Hello and welcome back to AP Tech Tutorials. In this video, I'm going to show you how to map network drive using group policy in Windows Server 2012 R2. This is my server. This is the Windows Server R2, as you can see there, standard version. And I'm going to show you the steps one by one. The first thing you need to do is just create folders. Let me show you the folder I just created. Of course, you can. This is for illustration purposes only, but these folders usually should be somewhere in a network storage. So I created two folders, clerks and managers, and I put a document, one document inside of each folder. I also went in and provided the permissioning and the sharing, and of course you need to allow the permissions. So this folder is only accessed by clerk and of course the lab admin. Clerks will only have the change permission. Do not provide full permission, because if you do, clerks will be able to change access to the full permission into this folder. So click OK and click OK here. And I did the same in the security tab. So as you can see there, clerk has also modified permission. Okay, and that's exactly the same thing for both folders. So clerk will access these folders and managers will access the folders. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to map this, and these two folders will show in the client's computer as a map drive. Okay, so that's how I did it. So let's go back to Active Directory's user assigned computer. And here I have two users, Jane Clerk for identification purposes, of course, and John Manager, okay? Both are members of the manager. John is a member of the manager group, and Jane is a member of the clerk group, okay? That's how I gave them access through the two folders. So let's, the most important part here now, it's let's jump into the group policy. You can do it by clicking on start and then looking for administrative tools and then group policy right here, okay? But I have a link here. I usually like to place shortcuts, which is faster and easy to access. So as you can see here, I created a map drive, but before I go there, let me show you how you can do it. You just put your mouse on top of the here, domain, and then create a GPO and then give it a name. I just named it map drive, okay? Right, and that's how I did it, okay? And I'm just gonna remove this one because I accidentally created it and I don't need it. So just let me remove it. And here, I also enforce it. Okay, so let's drill down to it. Right click, click on edit, and then navigate to user configuration, preferences, and then window settings and drive maps. Okay, then you get to this a window here, and this is where you actually create them. The only thing you need to do to create them is right click, create new map drive, and you will be prompted to for this window. How did I do it? Okay, first I just click on create, and then I copy this path. How do you do it? You just go into the clerk here, for example, but I prefer to do it with IP address. You can also do it just by saying DC1 and then enter it, and then clerk. You can do that if you want, but I know that the DC1 IP address is the 192.168.1.222, okay? And that is the folder right there, okay? That is the access. So I copied this one here, went back to the group policy, and when you click on this, I just came in and copy this path in there, reconnected logon, and then name clerk. So this is what the clients will see in their computer. The network map in their computer will read clerks. That's how it's gonna be. It's gonna see. It's gonna look. And then here on the drive letter, I use the letter G. Just doesn't matter. You can use any letter you want. I usually avoid using the letter C if it shows up. Sometimes it shows there. I usually avoid it because it creates conflict with the C drive on their machine. So I just click on create and that's it. Click apply. And then you see it turns green, which is good. It means it's working. So I do the same for the other one. I did exactly the same thing. I just click on create, copy and paste the path. I just named, labeled it manager, and I assigned the letter M for manager, click apply, okay, and that was it. Now, second step, and this is very important, okay? We need to update the network policy. We need to update the group policy, because if you don't, they will not show right away on your computers, so on your client's computer. So what do? You come here and then type GP update, and then force entered, and then the group policy will be updated, and you will need to do the same thing for your user's computer. I will not need to do it in this exercise because I already it's already configured and working fine and running. So I'm going back to my user's computer. In your case, you probably will need to reboot the user's computer to do this, or just by logging off and back on and updating the group policy. Remember to update the group policy because I believe it takes a little while for the domain controller to update the policy, so if in case you want to see it right away. So if I go back to the Windows computer, I'm just going to show you that in this computer, I'm logged in as Jane Clerk. I put the last name Clerk so you identify quickly with the folder that we just, the drive that we just mapped. And as you can see here, Jane has access to this folder because I gave her permission for that. But when she clicks on the manager folder, she will not have access to it. Okay. Same thing for the other user, which I name John Manager, as you can see here. And John also shows both map drive. If I click on Clerk, John is not going to see the folder Clerk, but if I click on Manager, John will see it. Okay, and that's the end of my video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, please click on the like button. And if you need some help or advice on something, just let me know and I'll jump in to help you. Thank you and have yourself a great day.